मॉर्निंग ऑल, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द प्रैक्टिकल दैट इज डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ ब्लड ग्रुप्स. मीन्स विच पर्सन इज हैविंग विच काइंड ऑफ ब्लड ग्रुप कैन बी डिटेक्टेड बाय सर्टन मेथड. दैट मेथड वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे, दैट इज डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ ब्लड ग्रुप. सो इफ वी सी द इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट द ब्लड ग्रुप्स, देयर आर फोर मेजर टाइप्स ऑफ ब्लड ग्रुप्स एंड एट डिफरेंट ब्लड टाइप्स that are collectively called as ABO blood group system. In theory, you have already studied that there are two types of blood group system, that is ABO blood group system and RH system. So now here, first of all, we are going to discuss about the ABO blood group system. So everyone knows that a person's RBC surface consists of an antigen, that is two types of antigen, antigen A and antigen B, and based upon this type of antigen the blood group is classified. That is, these groups are based on the presence or absence of two specific antigens and antibodies A and B. Now here following are the given blood group. According to that blood group, in that blood group we can say antigens and antibodies are present. If person is having blood group A, then his RBC surface will contain antigen A and plasma will contain antibody B. Blood group B consists of antigen B and antibody A. You have to remember that according to blood group, antigen is specified. Means if A blood group is present, antigen is A, but antibody is opposite, that is antibody B. Now in blood group AB, both antigens are present, that is antigen A and antigen B. But here the antibodies are absent. You have to remember that blood group AB consists of both antigen, antigen A and antigen B, but antibodies are absent. And blood group AB is known as universal recipient. Why it is known as universal recipient? Because it can obtain blood from any of these four blood groups. Next blood group is blood group O. Now blood group O doesn't contain antigen A nor antibody B, but blood group O consists of no antigens, that is it does not have antigen B and not a antigen A. So it have only antibodies, that is both A and B antibodies. Means you have to remember that blood group O has no antigen and both antibodies are present in this, that is antibody A and antibody B. Now on then this, there are third kind of antigen called as RH factor. In studied, you have already studied that. In theory, you have studied that RH factor is determined from the rhesus monkey. So it is known as RH factor. Based on the presence and absence of this antigen, the four blood groups are classified into eight different kinds. In simple language, you will remember that if the RH antigen is present, then your blood group is positive. If RH antigen is absent, your blood group is negative. So if a person having blood group A have positive RH antigen present on his RBC, then blood group will be A positive. Here actually given the presence of RH negative, but the concept is that if RH is present, then your blood group is positive. If RH is absent, then your blood group will be negative. Now the material required for performing the experiment is toothpicks. You will require 3 toothpicks, then blood sample, alcohol swab, then lancet, clean glass slide, sterile cotton balls and monoclonal antibodies, that is anti-A, anti-B and anti-D. Now if we can see it is a kit of monoclonal antibodies. It consists of three solution: anti-A antibody solution, anti-B antibody solution and anti-D antibody solution. Anti-D basically determines the RH factor, that is your blood group is positive or negative, and anti A and B will react with the antigen present in the blood, or we can say present on the RBC. Means we have studied that the blood group A has antigen A and antibody B. So anti A antibody will react with antigen A, as antibodies are opposite. But if we are taking anti A antibody and our blood group will be A, then it will react with that solution, or we can say it will react with anti A solution, and clumping or agglutination is observed. And in determining the blood group, we see the result by observing the agglutination. If agglutination is present in A part, means your blood group is A. If agglutination is present in B part, the blood group would be B. If agglutination is present in both A and B, then the blood group would be AB. And if no agglutination is found neither in A nor in B, then blood group would be O. And you have to remember, if agglutination is observed in B part, means your blood is of positive nature. And if agglutination is absent in D part, then your blood group is of negative nature. Now in procedure, what you have to do? You have to take a clean glass slide and draw a 3 circles on it with the help of the markers. Now you have to unpack the monoclonal antibodies, which is known as map kit. You have to, the circle you have drawn, in that circle you have to add the solution. That is, in first solution you will add anti A antibody, in second you will add anti B, and in third you will add anti D solution with the help of the dropper. The dropper is present in the kit itself. Then you have to keep the slide aside. You should keep it safely without disturbing it, so that the A portion drop would not mix with the B portion drop. Now you have to wipe your ring finger with the alcohol swab, and you have to rub gently near the finger tip, so that the blood force will increase to the finger tip and blood sample can be collected. Now what you have to do after rubbing your ring finger, you have to prick the ring finger with the lancet, or you can say pricking needle, and wipe out the first drop. Wipe out means you have to discard the first drop of the blood. Now as the blood started oozing out of the finger, allow it to fall on the 3 circles of the glass, that is in the A circle, B circle and D circle, by gently pressing your fingertip. Now you have to apply pressure on the site. Now blood is coming, you have to stop the blood flow. So you have to apply pressure on the site where it was pricked and stop the blood flow. If it is not stopping, then you can use a cotton ball for pressing and stopping the blood. Now you have to gently mix the sample with the help of the toothpick and wait for a minute to observe the result. You have to remember here that you have to use 3 toothpicks. First toothpick you will use for mixing the solution in the A, second is for solution in the B, and third is for mixing the solution and blood in the D portion. If you will use the same toothpick, then there would be mixing of the blood and your result will not be observed properly. Then now we are going to perform the actual practical.
So now we are going to perform the practical, that is determination of blood. The requirement for blood group practical, as we have discussed earlier, we will need the monoclonal antibody, that is this one is anti-A antibody, anti-B antibody and anti-D antibody. We have already studied that anti-A antibody will react with the antigen A, anti-B antibody will react with antigen B, and anti-D indicates the RH blood group, that is our blood group is of positive in nature or negative in nature. Along with the monoclonal antibodies, we will need a pricking needle. It is for the purpose of pricking that we are going to discard the drop of the blood on the slide. So Next requirement is pricking needle. Then we have to, we require some cotton swab which are deep in the alcohol so that while pricking we will disinfect our finger and then we will prick. And the last we will require is slide. You can take a plain slide or you can take a depression slide which will consist of three markings, that is A, B and D. You can circle it with the we can say with the marker, that is A, B and D. In A slide, we will put B anti-A antibody. Drop on A marking. Then you have to see properly that the anti-A antibody will be dropped on the portion which is marked as A, because it will react with antigen A and it will form a clumping. If clumps are formed, then we can take that our blood group is A. As we have already seen that the RBC contains antigen A and B and ABO blood group system. If anti-A antibody will form clumping with antigen A, then your blood type will be A. So we have put one drop of anti-A on marking A. Then we will put anti-B on the slide which is marked as B. And anti-D antibody drop will be put on marking D. Now, you have to take a ball of the cotton which is deep in the alcohol. You have to dip, or you have to clean or disinfect your finger which we are going to prick. Then you have to press that finger so that the blood circulation will be increased there, and you have to apply pressure near the tip of the finger so that the blood will get accumulated there. So you have to discard one drop of the blood, then put one drop of blood on A portion, then next drop on the B, and last one on the D. So now you have to take a toothpick or matchbox, toothpick or matchstick, and you have to properly mix that anti-A antibody and your blood. Then you have to remember that you should take this matchstick separate for each antibody, because if it will get mixed, the result won't be appeared proper. So next toothpick you will be used for B portion, and next you have to mix properly the part D, that is anti D, and your blood. Now you have to wait for some time so that you will see the clumping. Now you will observe the results, that A part does not form the clumping. B also clumping is not observed, means the blood group doesn't contains antigen A. It also doesn't contain antigen B, means the blood group is O. And we have already seen that the D part indicates positive or negative. So if clumping is present, it will be positive. If clumping is absent, then it will be negative. As we can clearly see that in the D portion, the clumping has been observed. So blood group is O positive. Why blood group is O positive? Because it doesn't contain antigen A, doesn't contain antigen B. But in B portion, that is in Rh factor, clumping has been observed. So the blood group is determined to be O positive. थैंक यू।